This is Story Recapped. Today, I'm going to explain a fantasy, comedy, and horror film called Piranha 3D. Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care. Lake Victoria local fisherman Matthew Boyd fishes in an isolated part of the lake while enjoying a bottle of beer. He catches a fish and reels it in but drops his beer. An earthquake hits as the bottle reaches the lake bed, and Matthew is above the epicenter. The earthquake breaks the lake bed below him into two, creating a whirlpool that slowly sucks the boat in and releasing thousands of prehistoric species of predator fish back into the face of the earth. Matthew eventually falls off his boat and the swarm of hungry piranhas get a taste of human meat for the first time, leaving only his gnawed and ragged corpse. It's spring break and the town population explodes as college students come over to celebrate the holiday. Jake Forrester is riding his scooter on his way to pick up his little sister, Laura, when he sees his mom, Sheriff Julie Forrester. Julie has her hands full with drunk partygoers and even arrests one after receiving inappropriate remarks to show that she's not someone to be messed with. Jake arrives and absorbs the spring break spirit when his crush, Kelly, gets his attention. They chat until Todd and his friend arrive to pick up Kelly. Todd is the reason that Jake couldn't make a move on Kelly, because they're dating. Todd has access to a backstage party for a concert, and Kelly invites Jake to come, but he's currently babysitting Laura and his little brother Zane. Todd's friend mocks Jake and throws a slushie at him as they drive away, ruining Jake's mood. Jake finds Laura talking to Danny, a sultry actress whom he thought was initially insulting him about his wet t-shirt, but turns out to actually be friendly. Danny's director, Derek Jones, arrives, and when he learns that Jake is a local, he convinces him to be his location scout for filming adult content the next day. Laura is about to reveal Jake's babysitting duties, but Jake covers her mouth before she can. That evening, Jake checks out Derek's adult website when Julie walks in on him to remind him about his babysitting job the next day. That same night, Julie gets called to an old dock by Deputy Fallon for a reported missing person, Matthew. While looking for clues, Julie learns that the USGS discovered seismic activities beneath the lake, and she's being requested to escort a team of seismologist divers to check out the epicenter. Subsequently, they find Matthew's empty boat among the reeds. Julie tries to haul it closer, but she falls into the lake. As she rises, Matthew's brutally mutilated body floats up, scaring her. Julie offers to close the lake until they find out what caused this, but Fallon says it's impossible since it's a big financial week for the town and because 20,000 people are partying. The next morning, a guy who goes cliff diving alone becomes food to the piranhas. Instead of fulfilling his babysitting duties, Jake decides to go with Derek's crew and bribes his siblings not to leave the house under any circumstances. The seismologist team arrives, team leader Novak, and divers Paula and Sam load their equipment onto Julie's patrol boat. Novak shows Julie the epicenter coordinates and they head out. Jake arrives at the quayside where he sees Derek and his actress Danny and Crystal dancing seductively in their boat, the Barracuda, while their cameraman Andrew records. They are at the center of the ongoing party. Jake heads to the boat but bumps into Kelly. Derek calls Jake, who initially ignores him, not wanting him to meet Kelly. Still, Derek approaches and sees how beautiful Kelly is, so he invites her aboard. Jake is vexed that Derek may use Kelly for his movies. Todd and his friend call out Kelly boarding Derek's boat, but Kelly dismisses them because they lied to her about having access to a concert. They get more annoyed as they see Jake, who smiles at them teasingly. Meanwhile, Zane and Laura break the deal with their brother as they paddle off to a small island in a canoe, wanting to fish. Kelly enjoys champagne with Derek and Crystal on the Barracuda while Jake sits with Andrew by the helm, giving directions as the crew's location scout. Jake still seems annoyed about Kelly coming. Danny notices this and points it out. Jake tells Danny, but more so to himself, that he doesn't care about Kelly's presence because she's not his girlfriend, and he's there to have a great time. They arrive at their location, where Danny and Crystal start swimming in the lake while Kelly is chilling by a floater. Jake goes inside the deck and sees Andrew and Derek filming Danny and Crystal swimming underwater through the boat's glass bottom. The boys admire and fantasize about the two girls. Julie calls Jake to check on them as nobody was answering the telephone at home. Jake lies that he's still at home and makes it more effective by bluffing about letting Julie talk to his siblings. Julie believes this, but tells Jake not to let them near the lake. After hanging up, Jake notices the floater that Kelly was on is now empty. Worried, Jake removes his clothes and jumps into the water, swimming towards the floater. Kelly, who's actually on the boat, calls for Jake, who's relieved to see her. As the two other girls climb back on the boat too, Zane and Laura reach the island but forget to tie up their canoe and it drifts away, stranding them there. Realizing their mistake, they worry about their big brother's reaction. Laura attempts to hail some passing boats multiple times but to no avail. In one attempt, she takes off her slippers and steps into the shallow part of the lake while a piranha is swimming around. She steps on a broken bottle and bleeds. The piranha smells the blood and quickly swims in her direction. Fortunately, she gets out of the water, unaware that she could have lost her foot if she had stayed any longer. Julie and Novak's team arrive at the epicenter of the earthquake. Through his digital field mapping device, Novak shows Julie the spot where the earthquake opened a connecting passage to a seemingly subterranean lake. Paula and Sam dive in to explore the chasm, communicating their status to Novak over the radio. Because the connecting passage is a one-person hole, Sam decides that he should go in first, while Paula remains at the entrance to maintain radio contact. Novak guides them through the mapping device, which also acts as a radar showing their location. Sam descends and discovers that the passage leads to an enormous underwater lake that looks like a massive sunken cave. He sees what seems like a tall plant, but is actually stalks of piranha eggs, and thousands of these cover the cavern. He removes his glove to touch it, but gets bitten by something swift and bleeds into the water. He reports it to Paula as he lights a flare. To his horror, hundreds of hungry piranhas surround him and charge in for a meal. Paula calls to Sam, but can only hear his cries as he gets devoured. Novak immediately puts on his suit and dives in to help. Paula swims in to check on Sam, but the mistake leads to her being their next meal. She tries to swim for her life, but only gets as far as the entrance of the passage, where Novak grabs her and swims back up. Julie hoists him up back into the boat, but only Novak makes it back safely, while Paula's body is barely recognizable with a living piranha clinging to her side. Unaware of the arising terror, Derek's crew and the Barracuda enjoy doing body shots with Crystal lying on a table. Derek invites Kelly to join, but she refuses. Derek persuades Jake to let Kelly join in, thinking that they're a couple. Jake affirms that they're not a couple, but still tells Kelly that she doesn't have to do it. Seemingly dismayed by Jake's response, she agrees to Derek's request to show that she doesn't have to listen to him, since they're not a couple. Kelly and Crystal's body shot leads to them kissing. Danny suggests that Jake and Kelly should play too. But just when Jake is close to getting on first base with Kelly through the lemon slice in her mouth, Kelly rushes to the side of the boat and pukes, clearly drunk and leaving Jake disappointed. Meanwhile, Novak and Julie take the piranha to Carl Goodman, a retired marine biologist who now owns a fish pet store with his wife. They pour the fish into a tank, and Goodman immediately recognizes it and compares it to a fossil that he has. Goodman identifies that this particular species of piranha is called the Pygocentris natureri, which became extinct more than 2 million years ago. These carnivores managed to survive below the surface without a food source for a long time because of cannibalism, as evidence of the piranha's scars. They hunt in packs in an organized and methodical manner. One bite draws out the blood, and the blood draws out the pack. Back in the Barracuda, Jake is recording a girl paragliding with her chest out for Derek's content when he spots his siblings from an island waving for help. Derek, who's busy getting high, gets mad when Jake stops recording. Jake forces Derek to rescue his siblings. Derek refuses at first as he's more focused on filming more content, but obliges to Jake's request when he discovers Jake's mom is the sheriff. Although they don't see it, the girl paragliding gets the lower half of her body eaten by piranhas. While the spring break party continues back at the beach, Julie, Novak, Fallon, and Deputy Taylor Roberts alarm everyone to get off the beach because of what's coming. Roberts gets their attention by firing warning shots, but instead of following the officer's orders, everyone resumes partying and starts jumping into the lake. Meanwhile, Jake successfully fetches his siblings off the island and scolds them. Derek, who's now drunk and high, demands to go to their next location. Jake takes his siblings inside together with Kelly, who's still a little drunk. Zane and Laura see the fish swimming below them through the boat's glass bottom, not knowing that they're predatory creatures. The boat suddenly stops because some lake plants tangle with the boat's propellers. After blaming Jake for all that's happened, Derek takes over the helm, pushing Andrew out of the way. A surge of panic replaces the party spirit when the piranhas choose a girl chilling in a floater as their first victim. Everyone swims for their lives, looking for higher ground as swarms of piranhas join the party. Julie and Novak help people into their patrol boat. Most of them evacuate to the floating stage, but it becomes overcrowded and capsizes, placing people back on the piranhas' menu. A cable swings wildly and slices a girl in half. Novak jumps out of the patrol boat and rides a jet ski with a shotgun, rescuing as many as he can. Julie shoots her taser into the water, electrocuting some of the piranhas and causing one to explode. One party host tries to pull himself up into a boat, but another boat hits him, and his brain scatters all over. Todd boards a speedboat and runs over a few of the injured people who are trying to swim for their lives. The speedboat stops when a girl's hair tangles with the propellers. The girl's scalp rips off as he continues to force the engine on. However, his boat capsizes as many of the people around him try to board it, and they all get eaten alive. Derek forces the Barracuda to start, but runs over some rocks, breaking the boat's glass bottom. Water floods into the room where Laura, Zane, and Kelly are in. The kids get out, but Kelly gets forced onto a countertop. Because of the impact, Derek, Crystal, and Andrew fall overboard. Piranhas swarm them, killing Crystal and Andrew while Derek struggles to save himself with Danny's help. Danny manages to haul in a half-eaten Derek, swatting the piranhas that came with him. He seemingly dies, and Danny covers him with a towel. Kelly is still trapped below the deck where aggressive piranhas are swarming. Jay communicates with her through the skylight as they figure a way out. Back at the beach, everyone struggles to get out of the water. Two men carrying an injured girl accidentally pull and split her in two. Most of them are severely injured with lost appendages, multiple patches of skin missing, and the lower half of their bodies fed to the fish. Fallon makes his last stand to protect the people rushing towards the beach by shooting piranhas with his shotgun. Out of bullets, he removes a rotor from a speedboat and uses its propellers as a chainsaw, which only worked for a short time, as more piranhas ultimately devour him. Julie is tending to the wounded when she receives a call from Jake, who feels guilty about the situation with his siblings. This worries Julie, but dread and panic wash over her as she discovers that their boat is sinking. Julie boards the nearest speedboat, jumping over capsized watercraft and floaters. Novak leaves his jet ski to come to Julie's aid. Jake, Danny, and the kids start to get hopeful at the sight of Julie and Novak. Since their boat is stuck in the rocks, it's impossible for the speedboat to come closer. Novak grabs the rope and Julie throws the one end at Jake, who ties it on the deck, while Julie ties the other end to the speedboat. Julie crosses the rope towards the Barracuda while Novak keeps the speedboat's motor on, heaving the rope so it stays suspended over the water. The family reunites, but Julie learns that Kelly is still trapped in the cabin. The skylight is too small for Kelly, who's now overcome with fear. Julie decides to let everyone cross the rope onto the speedboat first and come back for Kelly, but Jake insists on staying with Kelly until he figures out a way to save her. He blames himself for letting Kelly come with them, and now she's in danger. Julie hesitantly obliges and crosses back to the speedboat with her children, following Danny. Numerous piranhas are leaping out of the water, desperate to get a bite. Because of the weight of four people, the rope lowers towards the water until piranhas reach and latch onto Danny's hair, eventually dragging her down to her demise. Zane and Laura make it to the boat safely just before the bar where the rope is tied on the deck comes loose, submerging Julie into the water. Luckily, the loose bar gets stuck on another railing. Novak steps on the gas, heaving the rope and suspending Julie over the water as she clambers to safety. Below deck, piranhas threaten Kelly as she swats them with a frying pan. Jake removes the rope from the railing and ties it onto himself, connecting him to the speedboat. He takes Derek's body, who's surprisingly still alive, but dies seconds after. Jake throws the bloody Derek in the water to attract the piranhas. This gives Jake enough time to get to Kelly, who's relieved to be rescued. Jake asks her to tie two flares together while he releases the gas off some stored propane tanks. He radios Novak to start pulling them out 10 seconds after he gives the signal. Jake pulls Kelly close to him, giving Kelly assurance and security, and they kiss. He gives the signal, and the two swim towards the bottom of the boat. After 10 seconds, Novak struggles desperately to start the engine. Jake lights the flare and throws it to the boat, as piranhas rapidly close in on the couple. Jake sees them and protects Kelly by wrapping his arms around her. Finally, Novak starts the engine and steps on the gas, dragging the couple away from the piranhas and the boat. Simultaneously, the flare floats to the surface with the help of the open gas tanks. The air combusts, and the boat explodes, killing all the piranhas in the vicinity. They stop at a safe distance, quickly hoisting the couple out of the lake. After catching their breaths, Goodman radios Julie to tell her the bad news. He studied the specimen they brought him. The piranhas they were fighting against do not have mature reproductive organs, which means they're juveniles. Novak asks where the parents are, and an adult piranha, the size of a shark, leaps out of the water and eats them.
This is all for Story Recapped for today. Subscribe to watch more videos like this. Tell us in the comments if you want us to recap your favorite movie. Watch other of our videos showing on the screen and leave a like because it helps the channel. And I would see you in the next video. Goodbye.